Dominic Walsh is with Open Europe. Dominic, I want to ask you, first of all, on that line about Theresa May, I mean, how viable is it to simply bring Parliament back again, possibly again, possibly again, trying to get approval for the same deal?
Well, Jonah, constitutionally, it's actually quite difficult to bring back the exact same piece of legislation before the House again in the same session. Given the circumstances, they could probably get over that hurdle. But I think it's difficult to see her bringing it back again and again and again if there aren't any tweaks to it, if it hasn't been changed at all. And the question then is, what changes can she secure?
Well, that suggests she might have to rush off immediately to Brussels and hope against hope that they've got something else to give her.
Exactly. And the other problem with that is that she's facing a very quick turnaround, because thanks to an amendment passed last week, she now only has 3 days to come back to the House with her plan B rather than 21 as previously. So if she's got a plan B, she needs to come up with it very quickly and bring it back to the House.
Now, she seems to be determined that this deal is the only option available. She may have a point. You've written extensively about the fact that while there are other alternatives, there's simply no majority available for any of them.
I think that's exactly right. And I think the big problem we have at the moment is that Parliament's very clear about what it's against. It's against Theresa May's deal, as we'll probably see tonight. But it's not very clear about what it's for. And it's the other two main options are a second referendum and no deal at all. All the other Brexit options really aren't that different to the withdrawal agreement on the table, because they would involve the same withdrawal deal, but possibly some slightly different language on the future. And the different options for the future are open anyway under this deal.
And all the while, as all of this is going on, no deal continues to loom, because that requires a sort of affirmative action by the government in order to actually cancel it. They're not going to do that. Presumably, they're happy to have the prospect of no deal there as leverage against wavering MPs. But that raises the prospect of this country tripping out almost by accident.
Absolutely, yeah. And I think the problem is that she's been telling Brexiteers that if they don't vote for this deal, they'll end up with no Brexit. And she's been telling Remainers that if they don't vote for this deal, they'll end up with no deal. And the problem is that each side hears what the other side is being told. So the threat doesn't really work when you're trying to make two threats at the same time.
Extraordinary, isn't it, that we're just hours away from a vote in Parliament in which a sitting Prime Minister is about to suffer potentially a historic-sized defeat. And yet it may well, really, not take us anywhere.
No, exactly. And I think one of the main options for changing the picture, which is the vote of no confidence in our own party, has already been passed, and so that can't be used again. Labour may well table a vote of no confidence in the government, but they'll probably lose that, because the Conservative Brexiteers and the DUP see the issue of confidence in the government as a separate issue to confidence in the deal. So they'll happily vote against the deal, but as soon as a vote of no confidence is called, they'll come back behind her, and we'll still have this government stumbling on from day to day, trying to get this thing through. But ultimately, I don't see how this doesn't get through without significant movement from Labour.